Hey, good morning, guys. What we learned in yesterday's class? Electric field due to dipole, right? Electric field due to dipole. Okay, what is the conclusion from this electric field due to dipole? Already in the day before yesterday's class, we discussed about what is the potential due to dipole, right? So this is the conclusion. Okay, potential due to dipole V equal to Qd cos theta by 4 epsilon r square, right? From that, electric field due to dipole is found by using E equal to minus delta V relation. Okay. But basically, that distribution is just like an spherical shape. Here we consider the spherical coordinate system instead of the Cartesian or cylindrical coordinate system. Okay. So from E equal to minus delta V relation, we found what is the electric field? E equal to Qd by 4 phi epsilon r cube. And 2 cos theta plus sine theta, okay, along r and theta directions, right? And one more important point here is the electric potential V is related with the distance as square of the distance between them, but the electric field is cube of the distance between them, inversely proportional to. Okay, that is the key point we observed. Okay, and the related problems are also same. Similarly, in the torque of an electric dipole in electric field, and when we place it one dipole in electric field, okay, what is the net torque imposed on that dipole? Okay, the relation is the net torque imposed on the electric dipole is simply the dipole moment in electric field as okay cross related, okay, or simply the cross product or perpendicular to each other. Okay, that's why here torque T equal to dipole moment Q into D cross E. Okay, from that what we get, okay, T equal to Qd cross E. Okay, for that we found some relations or associated problems to find that torque. Okay, right, so today's concept is how much energy stored in electrostatic field. Okay, what is the example for that electrostatic field? Is it able to store the energy? Is it possible? Okay, energy stored in electrostatic field, just like our human body. Okay, our human body contains some electrostatic field, right? Our human body also contains some electrostatic field. Okay, but the electrostatic field is always laid on the surface of our human body. Okay, that electrostatic field on the human surface is called RS. Okay, of course. From human body and before I mean actually on the surface of the human flesh, okay, and before the skin also some electrostatic field is there, okay, that is called inner aura. After the on the surface of that human flesh, okay, or human skin, okay, some electrostatic field is there, as a layer of electrostatic field is there, that is called outer aura. Okay. Okay, that is also we are able to find, okay, by using super wave amplifier. Okay, super wave amplifier is a Darlington pair. Okay, Darlington pair connection is simply treated as a super wave amplifier. Okay, and one transistor emitter is connected to another transistor base, and okay, load is connected at the emitter as LED. Okay, with the transistor base of the first transistor, the base of the first transistor is directly connected to human body with the touch plates. Okay, touch plate is nothing but one copper wire. Okay, that acts as a electrostatic field sensor. Okay, okay, and if that electrostatic field contains some energy, okay, if it contains energy, then only it is possible to okay detect the light, right? Okay, detect something that's static fields. Okay. That is easily found by using the super wave amplifier. See here how that energy is stored in electrostatic field, okay, from a single electron point of view. Okay, that is derived here. Okay, how the energy stored in electrostatic field and how the energy stored in electrostatic and magnetic fields, okay, that is E and H fields. These two are the concepts, okay, we want to discuss today. The energy stored in electrostatic field and energy stored in E and H fields. You see here, Of course, the best example for this energy stored in electrostatic field is the capacitor, right? How the energy stored in capacitor? How the capacitor stores the energy? Okay, capacitor always stores the energy in the form of electrostatic field, right? Okay, similarly for magnetic fields, how the energy stored in magnetic field? Okay, inductor is the best example for how the energy stored in electromagnetic field. Okay, so that energy stored in electrostatic field, okay, is the best example for capacitor. See here, the energy stored in electric field due to n point charges. Okay, when we consider n point charges, means n electrons. Let us consider n electrons. Okay, and single each electron is the one point charge. Each electron is the one point charge. Okay, when we consider n electrons, okay, then we are able to consider n point charges. Okay, the energy stored in electric field due to n point charges is simply expressed as, okay, energy stored. But see here, okay, that energy stored representation is, okay, that energy, okay, or power, okay, is measured in watts, right? So that's why here the energy stored in electrostatic field is represented with the W. Okay, suffix E means the energy stored. Okay, so W suffix E equal to 1/2. It means it always gives us the average relation. Okay, energy stored in electric field due to n point charges is expressed as W suffix E equal to 1/2. Okay, summation of I equal to 1 to n. Okay, at n point charges. Okay, Vi into Qi joules. Vi into Qi joules, where V is the potential and Q is the charge. Okay, point charge. Okay, finally, you have to prove the same. Okay, in conclusion with this concept. Okay. Consider free space. Okay, consider free space and assume there is no electric field. Okay, and if it is in the presence of the electric field, then it is quite different. Okay, so that is what comes under the concept of torque, right? Okay, consider free space where there is no electric field. Okay, let it be point charge Q1 is moved from infinity to point one. Okay, but actually the work done by moving charge from infinite point to, okay, some point one. Okay, let us assume. Okay. Okay, since there is no field, okay, because there is no field, okay, the work done is zero, right? So W1 equal to zero. Now, due to that Q1 in the free space, an electric field is established now. Okay, get it? Why W1 is zero? Initially, there is no electric field. Why? Because there is no charges, right? Okay, there is no charges. Okay, there is no electric field. Initially, there is no electric field, but I am moving charge Q1. Actually, the charge Q1 is located at infinite point, that infinite point to some point one. Okay, when we consider an arbitrary space, okay, when we consider an arbitrary space, initially there is no electric field is there. That's why there is no work done. Okay, that's why the work done by that moving charge Q1 is zero initially. Next, if a point charge Q2, which is actually located in again point, infinite point, and moving to point two, because of the charge Q1 is already established in the arbitrary space, because of that Q1, okay, that Q2 is moving from infinite point to point two. Okay, because of this Q1 and Q2, there exists a work, right? Okay, that's why, because of the point charge Q2, it is actually moved from infinite point to point two in this field, and that because of this point one, because of this point Q1, okay, there is a possibility of existing some electric field, right? Okay, work done is zero, but there is a possibility of existing electric field. Because of that electric field, okay, point charge Q2 is moved from infinite point to point two. Okay,
the work done is work done in keeping Q2 is W2 equal to actually W sorry V21 into Q2. Okay, already you know the work done okay is the product of potential into charge, right? W2 equal to V into Q. Generally W work done equal to V into Q, or simply potential equal to work done by charge. Already you know that relation. Okay, so from that work done W2 equal to V21 into Q2, where V21 is the potential point 2 due to Q1. Okay, because of there exists a potential difference between 2 to 1. Because of that, there exists some potential at point 2 due to Q1. Okay, now the field increases due to Q1 and Q2 differences. Okay, if another point charge V3 is moved from infinite point to point 3, in this field, the work done in moving charge Q3 is W3 equal to V31 Q3 plus V3 to Q3. Okay, and 3 to 1, 2 to 3. Okay, because of the 1, because of the 2 on 3, that's why that is equal to V3 because of 1 into Q3, okay, V3 because of 2, Q2, okay, Q3, okay. Similarly, for what is the W4? W4 equal to V41, V41, V42, V43 because of Q4, 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 okay. Where V31 is the potential at point 3 due to Q1, V32 is the potential of point 3 due to Q2. Similarly, if the point charges Q4, Q5, from so on Q of n minus 1 are moved into this field, okay, what is the expression? We equal to Vn1, Vn2, Vn3, up to so on Vnn minus 1, okay, upon moving charge Q, right? So here, the nth number of charge, right? So Qn, 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 and okay, with all the potentials, okay, the total work done, how much the total work done in positioning all the point charges in the respective points is, okay, the total work done in W equal to W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus up to so on Wn. Simply we have to substitute all those. W1 equal to 0. Why? Initially there is no electric field, right? There is no electric field at the time moving that point charge Q1 from infinite location to point 1. Initially there is no electric field, that's why there is no work done. Okay, but when we moving the charge Q2 from infinite point to point 2, because of the Q1 and Q2 difference, there is a work done. Okay, that's why W2, V21, Q2, V3, okay, V3, 1, V3, 2 upon Q3. Similarly, 4, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3 upon Q4, up to so on Wn, okay, Vn1, N2, N3 up to upon Qn, right? Okay, now, okay, for the simplification of that above expression,
అమ్మ మెరంజీ ఫోన్ చేయండి
ఓకే ఫర్ ది సింప్లిఫికేషన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబవ్ ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్ ఓకే సింప్లీ ఐ యామ్ యాడింగ్ ది ఈక్వేషన్ ఓకే 2.129 with the above equation. Okay, this is the okay. This is the equation 128. Okay, WE. Okay. By simplifying this above expression by taking the term charge Q. Okay. Q. Let us say that is Q1, Q2, Q3, up to so on Qn. Okay. Okay, with retaining the potentials. Then V1 equal to V12, V13, V14, so on, V1, V1n, okay? And that at Q2, okay, is how much the potential is? Yeah, upon action, okay? For Q2, that is V21, V22, V23. Similarly, up to so on Vn, Vn11, it is the same above expression, but the that expression is splitted here. That's all, that is the difference, okay? Just I am adding these two expressions, Okay, 2WE equal to Q1 V1, Q2 V2, Q3 V3, so on, Qn Vn. So WE equal to how much it is? Okay, dividing with 2 on both sides. WE equal to 1 by 2 into Q1 V1 plus Q2 V2 plus Q3 V3, so on, Qn Vn. Okay. Thus, the potential energy stored in the electric field is how much? 1 by 2, simply summation of I equal to 1 to n. Okay, here 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Okay, let us say this is I equal to 1 to n. Okay, I've added from 1 to n. So, Qi into Vi, We equal to 1 by 2 into summation of I equal to 1 to n, Qi into Vi Joules. Okay, similarly, for a line charge of charge density, rho L, that energy stored We equal to 1 by 2 into same, okay, line integral of, where Q is replaced with integral rho L dl, that is already you know that relation. Q equal to integral, okay, actually rho L equal to what is the relation? So rho L equal to Q by L, right? Okay, for a differential length, we consider this relation as dQ by dL, right? So from this, dQ equal to rho L into dL, right? Okay, from this, what is the Q? Q equal to simply rho L into dL, right? So this is the equation here. Okay, instead of Q, they put here. Okay, Qi equal to integral rho L dL. Okay, integral rho L dL, line integral of. Okay, in this way, we get this relation. Is it clear? Okay, similarly for the surface charge density, simply We equal to 1 by 2, okay, surface integral of V into rho S dS. Okay, similarly for volume charge density, We equal to 1 by 2 into integral of V rho V dV. That's all. Okay, did you get it? Okay, this is the energy stored in line charge, surface charge, and volume charge densities. Okay, did you get it? Is it clear? Okay, this is very, very important concept. Energy stored in electrostatic field. How do we started this derivation? Simply, I am considering the one arbitrary space initially that is not having any electric field, but just I am moving some point charge Q1, which is actually located at infinite point, and by applying some force, with that force, just I am keep moving that point charge Q1 to the known point in arbitrary space. Okay, but initially there is no electric field, that's why there is no work done. So W1 is always zero. Okay, similarly, by applying some force on point charge Q2, which is located at infinite point, is moving to point 2. But because of the presence of Q1 in arbitrary space, there is some electric field is there because of that Q1. Okay, before the Q1, there is no electric field. Remember that point. Because of that, okay, some work done is occurred, right? Okay, what is the work done occurred due to that point charge Q2? Okay. Is simply W2. W2 equal to V21 into Q2. What is the V21? The potential existed due to these two point charges, right? That is the V21. Okay. But actually, that work done occurred due to which charge? Point charge Q2, right? Similarly, work done u2, q3, work done 4, work done 5, work done 6, okay, because of the potential differences and because of the charges, okay, moving from infinite point to, okay, arbitrary space. Okay, this is the conclusion. Okay, what is the conclusion? There's the potential of energy stored in the electric field WG equal to 1 by 2 into summation of I equal to 1 to n QI into VI joules. This much of energy is there in the field, okay, because of the charges and potential differences. Now, the same concept is applied to line charge, surface charge, and volume charge. Okay, for the line charge is how much the line charge density is rho L, then energy stored in line is 1 by 2 into line integral of V dot rho L into dl. How do you get this is already, you know, okay. Similarly for surface charge, 1 by 2 into surface integral of V into rho S ds. Similarly for volume charge, WG equal to 1 by 2 into integral V rho V dV. Okay, that is the one part of that, energy stored in fields. And next concept is energy stored in terms of E and H, okay. How the energy is stored in terms of electric and magnetic fields. Okay, how the energy is stored in terms of electric and magnetic fields. Okay, let us consider that volume charge density rho V. Okay, consider volume charge density rho V existing in a volume with applied potential V volts. Okay, we know that energy stored in volume charge density from the wave expression is WG equal to 1 by 2 into volume integral of V into rho V dV joules, right? Okay, but as per the Gauss law, what is the Gauss law? Okay, what is the conclusion from the Gauss law? Okay, Gauss law in point form. Okay, what is the Gauss law in integral form? Okay. Gauss law in integral form. Okay, Gauss law in integral form is okay. Okay, total flux density is charge enclosed by that surface, right? Okay, simply what is the point form of the Gauss law? Okay, what is the point form of the Gauss law? Okay, del dot D equal to rho V, right? Del dot D equal to rho V. Del dot D equal to rho V. Okay, and simply integral d dot ds equal to q enclosed, right? Okay, that is the integral form of the Gauss law. But same point form of the Gauss law is simply del dot d equal to rho v. Okay, what is the d here? D equal to epsilon e. That is already, you know, d equal to epsilon e relation is also already, you know. Okay, so w e equal to simply that rho v is replaced. Okay, with del dot epsilon e, but epsilon is a constant, right? That's why. So, take it out. Okay, WG equal to epsilon by 2 volume integral of V of del dot E dV. Get it? Energy stored in terms of electric and magnetic fields, that is proved by considering the volume charge density. Okay, consider volume charge density rho V existing in a volume with applied potential V volts. We know that energy stored WG equal to 1 by 2 into volume integral of V into rho V dV. From the Gauss law, rho v equal to del dot d, where d equal to epsilon e, right? Okay. So w e equal to, simply I am substituting del dot epsilon e here. So when we take the common term, we take the that constant term epsilon. Already you know what is meant by epsilon? What is meant by epsilon? Epsilon equal to basically that epsilon naught into epsilon r. The epsilon r value is 1. But epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10 power minus 12 okay, farad per meter. W e equal epsilon by 2, okay, integral of V of del dot E dV, okay, using this vector identity, okay, using the vector identity, okay, del dot E of V, okay, this relation, okay, V of del dot E equal to del dot V E minus E minus E dot del V, okay, this is the associative property or simply with the vector identity, okay, del dot E of V equal to del dot V E minus E dot del V. Okay, by using this vector identity, simply replace V of del dot E. Okay, what is the V of del dot E? Simply epsilon by 2 volume integral of, okay, replace this expression with this term. Okay, del dot VG of dV. Del dot VE of dV minus integral of E dot del V of dV. Okay, by using the divergence theorem, okay, already you know, okay, divergence theorem. Okay, since no closed surface enclosed by E, right? So, volume integral of del dot VE of dV equal to closed integral of VE dot ds equal to 0, okay, closed integral, or simply that divergence of that volume integral of the electric field is always 0, okay, or simply in the closed surface the electric potential is always 0. Already you know, for the short circuit conditions, okay, for the short circuit conditions, is there exist any potential? There is no potential existed, okay, because of this relation, okay, integral of del dot ve of dv equal to 0, okay, that's why this term is 0. So we equal to, okay, minus of epsilon by 2 volume integral of e dot del v of dv, okay, we know that e equal to minus del v relation, right? E equal to minus del v, kada? So that del v is replaced with, okay, that del v of minus is replaced with E. Okay, so W E equal to epsilon by 2 volume integral E. This del V is replaced with minus del V is replaced with E from this relation. Okay, E into E is E square, right? So W E equal to epsilon by 2. Okay, this is the epsilon by 2. E into E is E square of dV. Okay, so W E equal to R, this is the another relation, okay, volume integral of 1 by 2 epsilon E square of dV, okay, or simply epsilon E, what is meant by epsilon E? Epsilon E is nothing but D, right? That's why, can I write this epsilon E square as epsilon into E into E? So epsilon into E is replaced with D and another E is there. So volume integral of 1 by 2 D into E, into dV joules, okay, and this much of energy is stored in, okay, electric and magnetic fields, okay, WE equal to volume integral of, okay, these are all possibilities, right, okay, that E equal to, okay, Q equal to, one by mu, okay, Q epsilon, okay, and this is the one alternate form, okay, remember any one form, okay, don't confuse. Okay, so the energy stored in electrostatic field, okay, therefore the energy density in the electrostatic field W E equal to 1 by 2 into epsilon E square equal to 1 by 2 into D epsilon, DE, or equal to 1 by 2 epsilon into D square. Okay, these are all possibilities of energy stored in E and H fields. Okay,
That is the today's concept.
Is it clear? Okay, how much the energy stored in electric and magnetic fields and okay, and energy stored in electrostatic field. Okay, energy stored in electric field, electrostatic field, and energy stored in terms of E and H fields. Okay, these two are the today's concepts. Okay, and almost with this topic, the part is over. Okay, the unit is over. Okay, if the any concepts available miscellaneous, okay, I will cover in the next class. Okay, I hope you understand the today's concept. Okay, because this is very, very important. Okay. So I will continue this class, okay, tomorrow, yeah, day after tomorrow, okay. Okay, that's all for today. Okay, thank you, everybody.